Hey everyone, graphics cards use a slightly different type of memory, or VRAM, to the rest of the PC. The latest version of GPU memory is known as GDDR6, and while GDDR7 is due at some point next year, it'll be fairly expensive and in short supply, meaning that 99% of people will carry on using GDDR6 cards throughout 2024 at the very least. But if you've gone GPU shopping recently, you might have noticed that there are two types of 6 VRAM. GDDR6 and GDDR6X. So what gives? Which is better, and more importantly, which type should you buy? Well, GDDR6X is technically better. In theory, it offers up to 50% better performance. But in reality, many detailed benchmarks only show a 5 to 10% real-world improvement when gaming. Case in point, the NVIDIA RTX 3060 Ti comes with both VRAM types. The X variant is faster, but only by 7 to 10%. And the power usage of the card is up to 10% higher too, so it's not like GDDR6X memory has magically increased performance. You'd be paying more for the card itself, but also in higher electricity costs too. Now, if you don't mind this higher cost, then GDDR6X might be the best option for you. Unless you like AMD. AMD do not offer GDDR6X memory on any of their cards. They've stuck to the slightly older GDDR6 standard. There's two main reasons why they've done this. Firstly, so that they could offer more VRAM to their customers, and secondly, to try and limit the price of their cards a bit. GDDR6X is a bit more expensive to produce. These two points kinda go hand in hand though, and what you will notice is that AMD's cards tend to offer more VRAM than NVIDIA's equivalent card. For example, the NVIDIA RTX 3070 Ti offers just 8 gigs of GDDR6X VRAM, whereas the cheaper AMD RX 6070 XT offers 12 gigs of standard GDDR6 VRAM. But which is better? Well, a really useful video by Games Oracle compares these two cards in loads of games, and the NVIDIA card is usually slightly faster than the AMD one. So that's a clear win for GDDR6X, right? Well, not really. NVIDIA have received lots of criticism in recent months because 8 gigs of VRAM is simply not enough anymore. So many PC games nowadays are unoptimized lumps of crap. Sorry, what was I saying? Oh yes, many PC games nowadays require a lot of VRAM. That's totally what I meant to say. AMD's choice to offer slightly slower GDDR6 memory, but more of it, seems like a prescient decision nowadays. If you want to play, you know, all the latest games, then you might find an 8GB NVIDIA card to be lacking nowadays, even if it is the X variant. In this case, buying a GDDR6 card with more VRAM, like this one, might be best. Otherwise, you could hit a VRAM bottleneck. In other words, buying a GDDR6 card in 2024 is perfectly fine. That's actually why I purchased my RX 6700 XT. I regularly go over 8 gigs of VRAM when video editing and gaming, so I'm really glad I opted for this 12 gig card. I went over all my reasons for choosing this in another video, but what are your thoughts on this debate? Please let me know down in the comments. And that's pretty much all there is to it. Before finishing though, I wanted to answer one final question. Should you wait for GDDR7 to come out before buying a new graphics card? So, I'm shooting this at the very end of 2023, and there's not yet any clear announcements about when GDDR7 cards will be released. We don't know prices, exact release dates, or anything, really. Unless you're happy to wait 6 to 12 months and spend a lot of money on a flashy flagship GDDR7 card that will make your friends envious, then I would just buy a current-gen card. That wraps up today's quick video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. Please also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Thank you.